Cheers, darlings! This is Mettaton here, back for another adventure here in Undertale. We're gonna do the pacifist run here. Now, I have to apologize, darlings. I thought that one take was good, but apparently the director was like, nope, 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 the footage is all bad. We gotta retake this whole thing again. So, we're gonna have to reset all over again here. It's so disappointing, because all the footage from before just got really messed up, so hopefully here it's not gonna go so bad. Now we're just gonna put this up here, and then we'll have some little highlights later on, just for you all to have a little special time. So, come on, let's go ahead and reset here. Yes, we'll go ahead and leave it as that one, and just get right in here. So how are you darlings doing? Oh, and it looks like we are the human. Well, let's go and get this adventure started here. Oh, hello there. My name's Mettaton. Hello? Are you all right? Yeah, I'm fine. It seems like some flowers happened to break my fall. Broke my back a little bit too, but, you know, that's, I guess, to be expected. You must be so lost and confused. A little bit confused, yes. Where am I?
Ah, do not be afraid, my child. I am Toriel, caretaker of the ruins.
Okay, hello, Toriel. I am Mettaton, star of the underground.
I pass through here every day to see if anyone has fallen down. You are the first human to come here in a long time.
Oh, well, wait, I'm human? Nobody told me I would be playing a human.
I will do my best to protect you during your time here. Come, I shall guide you through the catacombs.
Okay, Goat Mama, please lead the way. Oh, nice little red flowers here. What is this? The shadow of the ruins looms above, filling you with determination. HP fully restored. Okay, well, that's a good start here. We get some determination going. Oh.
Welcome to your new home, innocent one. Allow me to educate you in the proper use and the operation of the ruins.
Okay.
Oh. The ruins are full of puzzles. Ancient fusions between diversions and door keys. One must solve them to move from room to room. Please adjust yourself to the sight of them.
What would happen if I happen to press one of these? Nothing. Nothing. Well, the door doesn't seem to close or anything. Huh. Only the fearless may proceed. Brave ones, foolish ones, both walk not the middle road. Huh. That's an interesting little thing. Great philosophy by someone.
To make progress here, you will need to trigger several switches. Do not worry, I have labeled the ones that you need to flip.
What does the sign say? Press Z to read signs. Well, great. I've already figured that one out on my own. And what about this? Stay on the path. On the path? I don't know about that. I think I'm just going to kind of walk around, not on the path. Defy all your expectations. I guess we'll flip that switch. And Goat Mama. See? Look at me. Look how defiant I am. You cannot control me. I'm not going to walk your... Wait. I have to get across the path somehow. No! I have not thought this through!
How am I supposed to do this, darlings?
No. That one.
No. You want to press the other switch. I even labeled it for you.
Well... I'm not one to follow rules, though.
No! You want to press the other switch. I even labeled it for you.
Well, I thought you would say something different, but I suppose not.
Splendid. I am proud of you, little one. Let us move to the next room.
I am proud of me, too, Goat Mama. How about we go this way? Hold on for one second. Still seeing me. I hope it's still seeing me. It looks like it's still seeing me.
As a human living in the underground, monsters may attack you. You will need to be prepared for this situation. However, worry not. The process is simple. When you encounter a monster, you will enter a fight. While you are in the fight, strike up a friendly conversation. Stall for time. I will come to resolve the conflict. Practice talking to the dummy.
Okay. Hello there, Mr. Dummy. I'm gonna kiss you on the nose. Oop. Oop. You encounter the dummy. Fight the dummy? No. We're not here to fight. We're here to love, darlings. We're here to love. What do we want to do? Let's check the dummy out. Dummy, attack 0, defense 0, cotton heart and a button eye. You are the apple of my eye. Aw, edge is so sweet. Now isn't it, darlings? It says nothing. Dummy looks like it's going to fall over. Well, let's try to talk with you. You talk to the dummy. It doesn't seem much for conversation. Toriel seems happy with you. You won! You earned 0 XP and 0 gold. Ah, very good. You are very good. Yes, I am very good. Thank you, Goat Mama. There is another puzzle in this room. I wonder if you can solve it. Beep, 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 like that. Beep. I remember this being told that there's another puzzle in this room, but... like, I don't actually see a puzzle here other than the fact that there's like this path, and then I think that she's just like, nope, let's walk this way. What's the puzzle? Well, I don't see anything. I'm pressing things and trying to do things, but I don't see a puzzle. Darlings, what am I supposed to do here? Am I supposed to just walk this path? That seems to be the thing I'm supposed to do. Well, whatever. Hey, try to talk to me. Frogget attacks you. Do I fight or do I act? Frogget! Let's compliment you. Frogget didn't understand what you said, but was flattered anyways. Oh. Goat Mama's giving a nasty, sneering look. Aw, oh, man. I won and earned 0 XP and 0 gold. The Western Room is the Eastern Room's blueprint. Okay. Let's go through. Go, Mama, I can't get past you. Fine.
This is the puzzle, but... here, take my hand for a moment.
Do I have to? I mean... yes, Tiffy, if I could actually figure it out. I mean, I could figure it out. Alright, well, we're just gonna walk this path, I guess. And I'm really short. Why am I so short? Get some little leg extensions or something.
Puzzles seem a little too dangerous for now.
I don't know. They don't seem that dangerous to me.
You have done excellently thus far, my child. However, I have a difficult request to ask of you. I would like to ask you to walk to the end of the room by yourself. Forgive me for this.
Oh. Did I go backwards? I want to go back into the spike room. I'm gonna do this. How about that? I'll check everything. Check everything. Is there anything in here? Anything? No, I guess not. Fine. Forget the path. Who needs paths? I don't need any paths in my life. I make my own path. Oh, what's over here? A whole bunch of stuff. Grass, 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 nothing. Okay. Thought it might be worth checking out. Oh, nope, nope. Nothing, nothing. Oh, Mama. Nope. She's just sitting there going, huh. Fine, I'll come on this side. How about that?
Greetings, my child. Do not worry, I did not leave you. I was merely behind this pillar the whole time. Thank you for trusting me.
Well, you're welcome.
However, there was an important reason for this exercise. To test your independence. I must attend to some business. You must stay alone for a while.
Was that test to see whether or not I'd walk on the path? Because clearly I didn't.
Please remain here. It's dangerous to explore by yourself. I have an idea. I will give you a cell phone.
Oh yay. Hope that's got enough minutes on it. I plan to text a lot of people.
If you have a need for anything, just call. Be good, alright?
Okay. Let's see. Hello.
This is Toriel. You only wanted to say hello?
Yes, hello.
Well then, hello. I hope that suffices.
It was kind of a weak laugh on my part. I do apologize. No. Click. I'm gonna just pace back and forth. Let's call about myself.
This is Toria. You want to know more about me? Well, I'm afraid there's not much to say. I'm just a silly little lady who worries too much.
Okay. You know what? Enough waiting. Hold on. Maybe we should actually call him. Let's see. Say hello, call her mom, flirt. Fine, we'll call her mom.
This is Toriel.
Go, mama.
Huh? You just called me mom? Well, I suppose. Would that make you happy? To call me mother? Well then, call me whatever you like.
You clearly wanted to be a mother. I feel like I can't tell if I'm wearing like pants and a striped shirt or if it's just a one piece. Kind of hard to tell. Let's go on.
Hello, this is Toriel. You have not left the room, have you? There are a few puzzles ahead that I have yet to explain. It'd be dangerous to try to solve them yourself. Be good, alright?
What if I go back? I go over here? You know what? Let's keep going. Let's just get going. Candy!
It says take one. Take a piece of candy.
Why yes, I feel like that is a great idea.
You took a piece of candy.
Proceed to open the menu. Okay. Take one, take a candy. Why yes, I think I shall take some more. I love all the candy.
You took more candy. How disgusting.
Oh, don't judge me. I'll have all the candy I want. I am Mettaton. I'm a star, baby.
Take one, take a candy.
Yes, I will take all the candy.
You took another candy.
You feel like the scum of the earth.
Maybe I am.
Don't judge me.
Take one, take a candy.
Yes, I think we should definitely. You took too much candy too fast. The candy spills on the floor. Let's check and make sure everything is looking good. Look at what you've done. Darlings, I feel so ashamed of myself. I just can't help myself. Candy is just too good. No, don't judge me. Do not judge me, darlings. I'll have all the candy I want if I want to. Playfully crinkle. Bah, I kind of messed up my lines there. Sorry, line. Playfully crinkling, that playfully crinkling through the leaves fills you with determination. HP fully restored. Save that for later. Hey, Hut, how you doing?
Ribbit. Excuse me, human. I have some advice for you about battling monsters. If you act a certain way or fight until you almost defeat them, they might not want to battle you anymore. If a monster does not want to fight you, please, use some mercy, human. Ribbit.
I think I will do that. Thank you. Thank you, kind little frog guy. Frogget hopped close. Now you want to fight me? How dare you? I'm going to compliment you. Frogget didn't understand what you said, but was flattered anyways.
Blushes deeply. Ribbit.
Oh. Stop that. Ow. That is not fair. Frogget, I'm going to spare you. Goodbye. You've won. Let's go on this way. Oh. Hey, who puts a hole here? Guess it's a good thing there's all these leaves. Leaves that break my feet and fall. Whimsun approaches meekly. Whimsun, I don't even think you want to fight. See you.
Ring. Hello? This is Toriel. For no reason in particular, which do you prefer? Cinnamon or butterscotch? Wait, do not tell me. Is it butterscotch?
Well, you told me not to tell you, but I kind of like butterscotch, yes. I do kind of like it. Let's say yes.
I had a feeling. When humans fall down here, strangely, I often feel like I already know them. Truthfully, when I first saw you, I felt like I was seeing an old friend for the first time. Strange, is it not? Well, thank you for your selection.
You're welcome. I wonder why she wanted to know if I liked butterscotch or not. Oh, another call.
Hello, this is Toriel. You do not dislike cinnamon, do you?
Actually, I might have an allergic reaction to it. It's fatal, you know, causes me to swell up massively, can't breathe, nothing like that.
I know what your preference is, but would you turn up your nose if you found it on your plate?
Well, I mean, no, I love cinnamon, but I might die. I just want you to know, I might die.
Right, I understand. Thank you for being patient, by the way.
Something tells me she's going to try to give me cinnamon, and I'm going to die. That just doesn't seem all... That doesn't seem appropriate. Okay, darlings, let's see here. Push a rock. And... Oh. Hello. Froggit hopped close. Compliment. Take my compliments, Froggit. You are very fabulous. Remember to live that fabulous dream in your heart. Go forth, darling, and be free. Okay, what does this say? 3 out of 4 gray rocks recommend you push them. What about the fourth one? What do they want? You ever stop to consider what that last one wanted, darling? Let's see. Do I go... I'm trying to remember this one. It's this way. Then this way. Oh, a little bit too far. Okay, so that's the path there. Oh. Old small blocks away. Spare you. Goodbye. So let's try this again. So we know here, that's too far, and up here, then over here. There we go. Okay. Now you, over here. Nope. Well, small. Why are you getting in my way? Please, just go ahead and be mercied already. Okay, and... Oh.
Whoa there, partner! Who said you could push me around?
Wait, are you that fourth rock? See, I was asking why exactly they think that it would be good to just go ahead and push you around when you don't like it.
Huh? So you're asking me to move over?
Why, yes, if you would kindly please move over to that switch, that'd be grueler.
That. Bah, 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 bah.
Sorry. That'd be glorious. That'd be glorious, darling.
Okay, just for you, pumpkin.
Could you move over a little bit more, please?
Hmm? You want me to move some more?
Yes. Please, move just over there.
Alright, how's this?
No, not there.
Hmm? That was the wrong direction? Okay, think I got it.
Yeah. Ah, there you go. Thank you. Thank you, darling. Thank you. But, hey! Why do you do that?
Hmm? You wanted me to stay there? Ah, you're giving me a real workout here.
Alright, that's better. Thank you.
Aren't things easier when you just ask?
Well, yeah, it's quite a lot easier if you just ask.
In the middle mouse hole.
It squeaks!
Hello, little tiny mouse. I'm Mettaton. Pleased to meet you. I hope you watch the Mettaton show.
Moving some cheese here.
This cheese has been here quite a long time. It's stuck to the table.
Aw. I would have liked some cheese.
I'm gonna have to get my dresser to get me a cheese plate later on.
Knowing a mouse might one day leave its hole and get the cheese.
It fills you with determination.
Alright, let's go forth with my determination.
Oh, hello there.
Are they gone yet?
This ghost keeps saying zzzz out loud repeatedly, pretending to sleep. Move it with force.
Yes.
Here comes Napsablook. Oh, Napsablook, how you doing, darling? You look like you're a little bit sad.
Let's try to cheer you up, how about that? You gave Napsabluk a patient smile.
I love this little funky beat, darlings.
Napsabluk looks just a little bit better. Let's try to cheer you up. You told Napsabluk a little joke. Really not feeling up to it right now. Sorry. Cheering seems to have improved Napsabluk's mood again. Let's cheer you up once more. Napsabluk wants to show you something. Let me try.
I call it Dapperbluk. Do you like it?
Why, yes, I do, darling. It's absolutely fabulous. Let's try to flirt with you, baby.
Oh no. I usually come to the ruins because there's nobody around. But today I met somebody nice. Oh, I'm rambling again. I'll get out of your way.
Come back and meet me again sometime, darling. I think you'll be fun to entertain and dance around with. What's over here? Spider Bake Sale. All proceeds go to real spiders. Well, where's the bake sale? They come too late for it. Leave 7G in the web. I don't really have it. Didn't have enough gold. I just wanted to leave some for them. Leave 18G in the web. I don't have any. Well, sorry, I would have left some for you, but apparently I don't have any. Did you miss it? Spider bake sale down and to the right. Come eat food made by spiders, for spiders, of spiders. Which is it of spiders? That's kind of a little bit cannibalistic, don't you think? I suppose some spiders might be cannibalistic, actually.
Ribbit, ribbit. Sigh. My friends never listen to me. Whenever I talk, they skip through my words by pressing X. That's right, pressing X. Well, at least you listen to me.
I was trying to press X. Apparently you didn't listen.
Ribbit, ribbit. I heard using F4 can make you have a full screen. But what does F4 stand for? Four frogs? I have only seen a maximum of three frogs in this room. This is troubling, to say the least.
Ribbit. What about over here? It's over here somewhere. There is an ant-sized frog in the crack in the wall. It waves at you. Hello, little tiny ant-sized frog. I hope you are filled with determination.
Look, strew near.
Let's not pick on you.
Finally, someone gets it.
Boom. There we go.
Looks is staring right through you.
Spare you. See ya. Alright, darlings, what about this one?
Ribbit, ribbit. I have heard you are quite merciful, poor human. Surely you know by now monsters wear a yellow name when you can spare it. What do you think of that?
Very helpful.
It is rather helpful. Remember, sparing is just saying you won't fight. Maybe one day you'll have to do it even if their name isn't yellow.
Good to know, darling. Good to know. Oh.
Hello? I just realized that it has been a while since I have cleaned up. I was not expecting to have company so soon. There are probably a lot of things lying around here and there. You can pick them up, but do not carry more than you need. Someday you might see something you really like. You will want to leave room in your pockets for that.
Look. Thanks, Goat Mama. I will keep that in mind.
Look.
What is this?
There is just one switch.
Okay, so one switch and I think a whole bunch of holes. Oh, spike there. How about this one? This one? Which one is it? Oh.
Vegetoid came out of the earth. Hello, Vegetoid. Want dinner? You pat your stomach. Vegetoid offers a healthy meal. Eat your greens.
Oh. Give me that one. No, I don't want the other ones.
Let's spare you now. Goodbye.
Okay, so we've got a bunch of these. Try this one. And there we go.
That is a switch, darling.
Okay. The far door is not an exit. It simply marks a rotation in perspective. What we need here is a little bit of perspective. So, okay. Oh. Migasp crawled up close. Spare you. La la, just be yourself. Yeah, dance, Migasp, dance! Migasp doesn't have a care in the world. Let's spare you two. See ya! Alright, darlings, let's see here. If you can read this, press the blue switch. Well, I don't see a pipe. Lux. Go away. I'm trying to do some work here, darling. The switch, press it. Yes. I heard a clicking and a sound. Okay, hey. Vegetoids. Come on, that's enough of this whole thing. Come on. You can read this, press the red switch. Okay. Can we just not, please? It is a switch. Go ahead and press it. Yep. And now... you can rest. Read this, press the green switch. Well, I'm gonna... I am getting a little bit... Alright, you know what? Go ahead and be not picked on. How about that? Oh. Oh. Alright, now will you go, darling? Thank you. There's a switch. Press it. Yes. Here we go. And... looks like we're getting closer. What is over here?
Ribbit, ribbit. Just between you and me. I saw Toriel come out of here a little while ago. She was carrying some groceries. I didn't ask what they were for. We're all too intimidated to talk to her.
Ribbit.
Okay. Hmm. Looks like Hamlet's happened here. I guess she'll just leave that. I have no need for it. Okay, so...
oh. Oh dear. That took longer than I thought it would.
Oh. Hello there, Goat Mama.
How did you get here, my child? Are you hurt?
Actually, I don't think I am. I don't think I've got any hits or anything.
Not a scratch. Impressive. But still, I should not have left you alone for so long. It was irresponsible to try to surprise you like this. Well, I suppose I cannot hide it any longer. Come, small one.
Okay. Oh, look at all these red leaves. Looks like a house, too. Seeing such a cute, tidy house in the ruins gives you determination. Okay. Sorry about that, darlings.
Do you smell that? Surprise! It is a butterscotch cinnamon pie.
Goat Mama, I was trying to tell you, I'm allergic to cinnamon. You might have wanted to... well... I'll still eat it. I love it. But you might want to have some, yeah, emergency medical stuff for that sort of thing around.
I thought we might celebrate your arrival. I want you to have a nice time living here. So I will hold off on snail pie for tonight.
But darling, I love escargot. You should have given me some of that. I would take that all.
Here, I have another surprise for you.
What's over this way? Oh, look at this. It's a nice little fireplace. Fire isn't burning hot, just pleasantly warm. You could put your hand inside. That doesn't seem like the best of ideas, darling.
It's a history book. Here's a random page. Trapped behind the barrier and fearful of further human attacks, we retreated. Far, far into the earth we walked until we reached the cavern's end. This was our new home, which we named Home. As great as our king is, he is pretty lousy at names.
I don't know, I kinda like the name Home, darling.
Oh, this is it. Oh, a room of your own. I hope you like it.
God, I must be such a midget.
Is something burning? Make yourself at home.
Okay, I will. What's that? I'm not sure what that is. You've seen this type of plant before, but don't know its name. Okay.
An empty photo frame. It's really dusty. A box of kids' shoes in a disparity of sizes. Look at these cool toys. They don't interest you at all.
Okay, well.
Such a charming song. Dun.
I think I'll go to bed and take a nap.
Oh.
Hello there. You found a slice of butterscotch cinnamon pie. Tasty! What's over here?
It's Toriel's diary.
Read the circled passage? Yes, darling. Let's see what kind of crazy thing she's getting into.
You read the passage. Why did the skeleton want a friend?
Because she was feeling bonely.
Aww, that's terrible.
That's terrible, darling. I love it.
The rest of the page is filled with jokes of a similar caliber. Just a regular old bucket of snails. Definitely bigger than a twin-sized bed.
It's an encyclopedia of subterranean plants. You open to the middle.
Typha. A group of wetland flowering plants with brown oblong seed pods. Known more commonly as water sausages.
Huh, that was interesting. Water sausages. Who'd ever thought of having a water sausage?
You peek inside. Scandalous. It's Toriel's sock drawer.
Ah, the cactus. Truly the most sundere of plants.
What makes it sundere, darling? I don't even know.
Huh. Well, what is this? Room under renovations.
It's you.
Yes, it is me, darlings.
Oh, it is a water sausage.
Okay, well, I think that we should go and see Goat Mama.
Hello, Goat Mama.
What are you up to?
Up already, I see. I want you to know how glad I am to have someone here. There are so many old books I want to share. I want to show you my favorite bug hunting spot. I've also prepared a curriculum for your education. This may come as a surprise to you, but I've always wanted to be a teacher.
Really? That's interesting. I can see you being a good teacher.
Actually, perhaps that isn't very surprising. Still, I'm glad to have you living here. Oh, did you want something? What is it?
Nothing.
Well, talk to me again if you need anything.
Ooh, more pie. The size of the pie intimidates you too much for you to eat it. I don't know, I could eat the whole thing, darling. There's some white fur stuck in the drain.
The stovetop is very clean. Toriel must use fire magic instead.
Great old fire magic. Cooking the old-fashioned way.
Inside the cupboard are cookie cutters for gingerbread monsters.
Okay, and for some reason, there's a brand-name chocolate bar in the fridge. That's the best place to keep them. Nice and cold chocolate. Let's go ahead and talk with you again.
Oh, hello. Did you want to hear about the book I am reading? It is called 72 Uses for Snails. How about it?
Sure.
Here is an exciting snail fact. Did you know that snails make terrible shoelaces? Interesting.
Yeah.
Well, bother me if you need anything else.
Well, I kind of want to go ahead and exit the ruins now, I think.
I have to do something. Stay here.
Goat Mama! Goat Mama, what are you doing? Toriel!
Inside is an old calendar from the beginning of 2001X. Ah, my favorite year.
Well, darlings, let's see what's down here.
Oh. Ah, hello there.
You wish to know how to return home, do you not? Ahead of us lies the end of the ruins. A one-way exit to the rest of the underground. I'm going to destroy it. No one will ever be able to leave again. Now be a good child and go upstairs.
I almost wonder what would happen if I do go upstairs. Nothing. Okay. Well, I guess I'll just keep going.
Every human that falls down here meets the same fate. I have seen it again and again. They come. They leave. They die. You naive child, if you leave the ruins, they, Asgore, will kill you. I'm only protecting you. Do you not understand? Go to your room.
Goat Mama, I can't really do that. I've got to make the story progress, after all.
Do not try to stop me. This is your final warning.
Well, sorry. I don't listen that well.
You want to leave so badly? You're just like the others. There is only one solution to this. Prove yourself. Prove to me you are strong enough to survive. Wait. Why are you looking at me like that?
Like what?
Like you have seen a ghost. Do you know something that I do not?
Well, I might.
No, that's impossible.
Well, Toriel blocks away. I'm just gonna try and spare you, Goat Mama. Nothing, huh? Oh. There we go. I'm gonna keep sparing you. I do not want to fight, Goat Mama. Oh. Spare! No.
Spare you. What are you doing?
Oh, ow.
Attack or run away?
Ooh, ah. Crud.
What are you proving this way?
I'm proving that I do not need to fight you, Goat Mama. We do not need a fight. I'm gonna have some monster candy. Ooh. Ha! Goat Mama, we do not need to do things this way!
Fight me or leave.
Ooh. Ow. Ah. No. That did not heal me for that long.
Stop it.
No. I can't stop it. I'm filled with too much determination, darling. Toriel is acting aloof.
Stop looking at me that way.
I can't. Don't you understand, Goat Mama?
Oh.
Toriel takes a deep breath.
Go away.
Oh. And feel like we're wearing her out. Yeah, she's starting to get sad now, darlings.
Now she doesn't even want to fight anymore.
I know you want to go home, but... But please, go upstairs now.
I'm sorry. I can't do that. I have to progress the story.
I promise I will take good care of you here.
Oh.
I know we do not have much, but... We can have a good life here. Why are you making this so difficult? Please, go upstairs.
Oh.
Pathetic, is it not? I cannot even save a single child. No. I understand. You would just be unhappy trapped down here. The ruins are very small once you get used to them. It would not be right for you to grow up in a place like this. My expectations, my loneliness, my fear. For you, my child, I will put them aside. If you truly wish to leave the ruins, I will not stop you. However, when you leave, please do not come back. I hope you understand.
Oh.
Goodbye, my child.
Goodbye, Goat Mama. I will always remember your goatiness and your mama-iness. I wonder where she went to. Are you back over here somewhere? I'll leave in a little bit, but I want to make sure I say goodbye to you properly. Still not around here either. Oh well. We'll just keep going forward. Onwards to adventure and to eventual victory. I hope that we're going to have victory. Pleasant thing to have victory. So, darlings, I think this is going to be a start of a glorious adventure here. This is a long journey. How much is certain? Huh. Nothing. Okay. Undertale by Toby Fox. Okay, well, I think before we get started with another section here, I'm going to take a little break. I'll be right back. Okay, give me one second here. We're gonna make sure that things calibrated. Calibrate me. Yeah, baby. Okay. Now, hopefully it'll also hide. Hide that, please. There we go. So, I'm back here. If you're watching me on the archive, hello. If you're not watching me on the archive and seeing me on the... what is it going to be? The highlights? Well, you won't even see this scene anyway, so... no problem. Alrighty, darlings. Let's go forward. There's a camera hidden in the bushes. Oh, darlings, it's my TV appearance. Hello, how is everybody out there in TV land? This is Mettaton here. Oh, okay, well, I guess we'll just keep going. So many trees around here. Looks cold, too. A little bit quiet and disturbing. Oh. Hello. Is anyone out there? Hello? Mysterious and spooky, darlings. Oh. Hello? What is this? Hello? Who's that behind me? Human. Hello there. Who are you? Sure, I'll shake your... wow. The old whoopee cushion in the hand trick. Wait a second. Have you heard it before or something? Ah, yes I have, darling. Yes I have. You turned around before I said to. Huh. Weird. Oh, whatever. You're a human, right? I'm Sans. Sans the skeleton. I'm actually supposed to be a watch for humans right now. But, you know. I don't really care about capturing anybody. Now my brother, Papyrus. He's a human hunting fanatic. Hey, actually I think that's him over there. I have an idea. Go through this gate thingy. Okay, yeah, go right through. My brother made the bars too wide to stop anyone. Okay. Oh. Quick! Behind that conveniently shaped lamp. It is rather conveniently shaped, isn't it? Sup, bro?
You know what's up, brother! It's been 8 days and you still haven't recalibrated your puzzles! You just hang around outside your station! What are you even doing?
Staring at this lamp. It's really cool. Do you want to look?
No, I don't have time for that. What if a human comes through here? I want to be ready. I will be the one. I must be the one. I will capture a human. Then I, the great Papyrus, will get all the things I utterly deserve. Respect! Recognition! I will finally be able to join the Royal Guard! People will ask to be my friend! I will bathe in a shower of kisses every morning!
Huh. Maybe this lamp will help you.
Sans, you are not helping! You lazy bones! All you do is sit and boondock! You get lazier and lazier every day!
Hey, take it easy. I've gotten a ton of work done today. A skeleton.
Oh, Sans!
Come on, you're smiling.
I am and I hate it! Why does someone as great as me have to do so much to get some recognition?
Wow, sounds like you're really working yourself. Down to the bone.
I will attend to my puzzles. As for your work, put a little more backbone into it.
Okay, you can come out now. Oh, man. Oh, you gotta love these guys. You ought to get going. He might come back, and if he does, you'll have to sit through more of my hilarious jokes. I don't know, I could enjoy that. It's some sort of checkpoint or sentry station, but there are bottles of ketchup, mustard, and relish sitting inside. Interesting. Actually, hey, hate to bother you, but can you do me a favor? Depends what the favor is. I was thinking, my brother's been kind of down lately. He's never seen a human before, and seeing you might just make his day. Don't worry, he's not dangerous. Even if he tries to be. Thanks a million. I'll be up ahead. Okay. The convenience of that lamp still fills you with determination. This is a box. You can put an item inside or take an item out. The same box will appear later, so do not worry about coming back. Sincerely, a box lover. Use the box, yes. I don't think I want tough glove. But I will just say, thank you. Oh. Snowdrake flutters forth. Let's tell you a couple of jokes. How about that? You make a bad ice pun. Nice try. Oh. Hey, watch it. Watch it. Snowdrake is assessing the crowd. How about I tell you another one? You made a bad ice pun. Haha, nice try. Okay. Snowdrake is smiling at his own bad jokes. How about I laugh? You laugh at Snowdrake before it says anything funny. Well, why did you not say anything? What are you laughing at? Okay, so... It smells like a wet pillow. Maybe I got a joke first. Is that supposed to be funny? Ow! Ow! That hurt. Practicing its next pun. How about I heckle him? You tell the Snowdrake that they aren't funny. Is your flesh rotten as you? Well, maybe. Snowdrake is practicing its next pun. How about we laugh now? Alright, you know what? I don't even know what's going to make you really... How about we laugh again? Still hasn't said anything funny. I'm laughing at you because you're not telling anything funny. Ah! Stop that. Let's just get out of here. It's not really working out too well, I think. Okay, I was going to go up here. Oop. It's a fishing rod affixed to the ground. Reel it in? Yes. All that's attached to the end is a photo of a weird-looking monster. Call me. Here's my number. You decide not to call. Great choice, human. I think that's a great choice. Let's get out of here before they try to call. So, as I was saying about Undyne... Whoa. Sans? Oh my god! Is that... a human? It looks so familiar.
I think it looks familiar. Because it's a rock?
Oh.
Hey, what's that in front of the rock?
Oh, oh my god! Is that a human?
Yes.
Oh my god! Sans, I finally did it! Undyne will... I'm gonna... I'll be so... Popular! Human! You shall not pass this area! I, the Great Papyrus, will stop you! I will then capture you! You'll be delivered to the capital! Then I'm not sure what happens next.
In any case, continue only if you dare!
Well, that went well. Don't sweat it, kid. I'll keep an eye socket out for you. Oh, you gotta love papyrus. There's some narration on this cardboard box.
You observe the well-crafted sentry station! Who could have built this, you wonder? I bet it was that very famous Royal Guardsman! No, not yet a very famous Royal Guardsman. Oh.
Huh. Icecap struts into view. Let's compliment you. You inform Icecap that it has a great hat.
My hat's too loud for me to hear you.
Oh, oh. Okay, we're gonna go this way. Here comes that new clothes smell. Doesn't seem to let me spare it yet. How about I ignore it? You manage to tear your eyes away from Icecap's hat. It looks annoyed.
Hello, my hat's up here!
Oh. Oh, oh. Oh. Okay. Secretly, Icecap is secretly checking if you're looking at its hat. How about we compliment it now? You inform Icecap that it has a great hat.
Envious? Too bad.
Ow. I'm gonna... No.
Snow?
No, it has something. I didn't read what it said. Okay. Let's just run. See ya!
Absolutely no moving!
Well, I'm gonna move anyway. Oop.
Did something move? Was that in my imagination?
I can only see things that move.
If something was moving, for example, a human, and make sure it never moves again.
Ooh. Doggo blocks away. Check it. Doggo 6. Attack, 1 defense. Easily excited by movement. Hobbies include squirrels. Don't move an inch. Okay. Doggo can't seem to find anything.
Pet you. You pet Doggo.
It's like, what?
I've been pet!
Pet, pot, pot, pet, pot, pet, 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 pot.
Doggo has been pet. Let's spare you. You won.
This is something pet me. Something that isn't moving. I'm gonna need some dog treats for this.
Hello? Room service?
Hello? Is anybody there?
No? Okay. Someone's been smoking dog treats.
Hey, here's something important to remember. My brother has a very special attack. If you see a blue attack, don't move and it won't hurt you. Here's an easy way to keep it in mind. Imagine a stop sign. When you see a stop sign, you stop, right? Stop signs are red, so imagine a blue stop sign instead. Simple, right? When fighting, think about blue stop signs.
Okay. Oh.
North, ice. South, ice. West, ice. East, snowed in town. And ice.
Okay. Oh, hello there.
Hello. I am a snowman. I want to see the world, but I cannot move. If you would be so kind, traveler, please take a piece of me and bring it very far away.
Yes.
Thank you. Good luck.
You got the snowman piece. Okie doke. And this way.
Oh. Really, though? That human? Do I know that person?
Do you not know who you know?
Of course I know who I know. I wanted to know if you know. I know who I know as much as I know who I know. You know? Oh, ho, ho. Speak of the devil. In order to stop you, my brother and I have created some puzzles.
I think you will find this one quite shocking. For you see, this is the invisible electricity maze. When you touch the walls of this maze, this orb will administer a hearty zap. Sounds like fun, because the amount of fun you will probably be having is actually rather small, I think. Okay, you can go ahead now.
Okay.
Ah! Sans! What did you do?
I think the human has to hold the orb.
Oh. Okay. Hold this, please.
Okay.
Okay, try now.
Okay. I think I'll just go like this way.
Incredible, you slippery snail. You solved it so easily.
Too easily.
However, the next puzzle will not be so easy. It is designed by my brother, Sans. You will surely be confounded. I know I am.
Hey, thanks. My brother seems like he's having fun. By the way, did you see that weird outfit he's wearing? We made that a few weeks ago for a costume party. He hasn't worn anything else since. Keeps calling it his battle body. Man, isn't my brother cool?
Well, sure, he's awesome. He's a hoot.
I don't understand why these aren't selling. It's the perfect weather for something cold. Oh, a customer! Hello, would you like some ice cream? It's the frozen treat that warms your heart. Now just 15G. Yes. Here you go, have a super duper day. You got the ice cream.
Okay. Let's see if we can get this thing in smoothly. Hold on. And down. Oh, I didn't kick it that way. And let's see here. Oh, hey. Don't drink too much. Don't shrink too much. There we go. No. Purple, even when you felt trapped, you took notes and achieved the end of ball. You're awarded 2G. Take it. I was hoping for more. It looks like a snowball. Actually, it's a snow decahedron. Okay. So, darlings. Oh, hello, Sans.
I've been thinking about selling treats, too. Want some fried snow? It's just 5G.
Sure.
Did I say 5G? I meant 50G.
Well, sure.
Really? How about 5,000G?
Well, you know, you're talking me into it. I just gotta...
50,000G. That's my final offer.
Sure, I'll buy it.
What? You don't have the money? Hey, that's okay. I don't have any snow.
Let's see here. Is? Hers. Smell danger rating. Snow smell? Snowman. White rating. Can become yellow rating.
Terrible. That's absolutely terrible, darlings.
Unsuspicious smell. Puppy. Blue rating. Smell of rolling around. Weird smell. Humans. Green rating, even though it's red. Destroy at all costs. Interesting. So, whoop, whoop, boom. Down here we go. Oh. Human! I hope you're ready for... Sans! Where's the puzzle?
It's right there, on the ground. Trust me. There's no way they can get past this one.
What is it? Monster Kids Word Search. Hey kids, can you help me solve this puzzle? You know what? I'm gone. Sans, the human is escaping! You made the puzzle too hard! Hey you, get back here!
Okay.
What'd you want?
sands, I didn't do anything!
Whoops. I knew I should have used today's crossword instead.
What, the crossword? I can't believe you said that! In my opinion!
Junior Jumble is easily the hardest. What? Really? Dude, that easy peasy word scramble? That's for baby bones.
Unbelievable! Human, solve this dispute! Which is harder?
Jumble or the crossword? Let's say Jumble.
Yes! Humans must be very intelligent if they also find Junior Jumble to be so difficult!
Thanks for saying Junior Jumble just to appease my brother. Yesterday he got stumped trying to solve the horoscope.
It's a note from Papyrus. Human, please enjoy this spaghetti. Little do you know, this spaghetti is a trap designed to entice you. You'll be so busy eating it that you won't even realize that you aren't progressing. Thoroughly shaped again by the great Papyrus. Papyrus.
It's a plate of frozen spaghetti. It's so cold, it's stuck to the table. It's an unplugged microwave. All of the settings say spaghetti. Well, guess I won't be able to enjoy that spaghetti. Knowing the mouse might one day find a way to heat up the spaghetti, it fills you with determination. Go ahead and save that. Okay. Warning. Dog marriage. Okay. Well, I think I'm gonna go over here and get attacked by lesser dog. Ooh. Hey, lesser dog. We have options to pet, 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 and pet. I think we'll just pet you. You barely lifted your hand and lesser dog got excited.
Oh, hi, doggy.
Lesser dog is barking excitedly. Let's pet you again. You lightly touch the dog. It's already overexcited.
Oh. Ah.
Lesser dog is barking excitedly. Pet you again. You pet the dog, it raises its head to meet your hand.
Hello, doggy. Little cute doggy.
Lesser dog is barking excitedly. You pet the dog, it was a good dog.
Excited noise. Whoa. Pet more.
You pet the dog, its excitement knows no bounds. Excited noises. Whoa, wow. Coming from the other way.
Critical pet! Dog excitement increased!
And now it is overstimulated. You have to jump up to pet the dog. Motor revving. You don't even pet it! It gets more excited! Flying takeoff. Oh, darlings, this dog is so fabulous. There is no way to stop this madness.
Kettle whistle.
Lesser dog enters the realm of the clouds! And you call the dog, but it is too late. It cannot hear you. Far away bark. Lesser dog shows no signs of stopping, but I think we shall. Go ahead and spare you now. There's a switch hidden in the snow. Click. Okie doke. Let's go down and meet the little doggies. Gotta get across here. Yep. Hello there. My name is Mettaton. How are you today?
What's that smell? Where's that smell?
If you're a smell, identify your smell.
There's that weird smell. It makes me want to
eliminate you. Hi there, doggies. Doggy assaults you. Doggy me and Doggerisa. I'm gonna roll around in the snow and the dirt. You smell like a weird puppy.
Let's kick human tail.
Do humans have tails? Oh. And, oh. Okay, here we go. The dogs may want to re-smell you. How about you re-sniff me? The dogs sniff you again. After rolling in the dirt, you smell alright.
What smells like it? Are you actually a little puppy?
Oop.
And back over here. Okay. The dogs think that you might be a lost pup. How about I pet you? You pet doggy me.
Wow! Pet by another puppy!
Well, don't leave me out. And up. And up. Oh. Whew, that was close. The dogs think that you may be a lost puppy. How about we pet you, too? You pet the dog eraser.
What about me? A dog that pets dogs. Amazing!
And there we go. And, oh, barely didn't get hit by that. Dogs' minds have been expanded so much that they can be spared now.
You won! Dogs can pet other dogs? A new world has opened up for us. Thanks, weird puppy.
You're welcome. Okay, so, let us keep going. Let's see, we need to turn this on, and this on.
Nope. What? How did you avoid my trap? And, more importantly, is there any left for me?
What do you tell Papyrus about his spaghetti? Ate it, left it. I left him some.
Really?
Wowie. You resisted the flavor of my home-cooked pasta just so you could share it with me? Fret not, human! I, Master Chef Papyrus, will make you all the pasta you could ever want!
Yeah. Alright, see you later. Let's get some pasta later on. How about that?
My brother started a sock collection recently.
How saddening.
Sometimes I wonder what he would do without such a cool guy taking care of him.
Interesting. Sock collection. Oh.
Human!
How do I say this?
You were taking a long time to arrive, so I decided to improve this puzzle by arranging the snow to look more like my face. Unfortunately, the snow froze to the ground. Now the solution is different. And, as usual, my lazy brother is nowhere around. I suppose what I am saying is, worry not, human! I, the great Papyrus, will solve this conundrum. Then we can both proceed. Meanwhile, feel free to try the puzzle yourself.
I'll try not to give away the answer. Okay. Turn every X into an O, then press the switch. Okay, so let's see here. I think that I want to start this way, then go down here. Crud. I messed that up. Alright, so I'm gonna start like this, then get off of there, then do that, and over here. There we go.
Wow! You solved it! And you did it all without my help! Incredible! I'm impressed! You must care about puzzles like I do! Well, I'm sure you'll love the next puzzle then! It might even be too easy for you!
Yeah!
Ah, Papyrus, I love you, buddy! Oh, hello. Good job on solving it so quickly. You didn't even need my help. Which is great, because I love doing absolutely nothing. Okay.
Oh. Hey! It's a human! You're gonna love this puzzle. It was made by the great Dr. Alphys. You see these tiles? Once I throw the switch, they will begin to change color. Each color has a different function. Red tiles are impassable. You cannot walk on them. Yellow tiles are electric. They will electrocute you. Green tiles are alarm tiles. If you step on them, you will have to fight a monster. Orange tiles are orange scented. They will make you smell delicious. Blue tiles are water tiles. Swim through if you like, but if you smell like oranges, the piranhas will bite you. Also, if your blue tile is next to a yellow tile, the water will also zap you. Purple tiles are slippery. You will slide to the next tile. However, the slippery soap smells like lemons, which the piranhas do like. Purple and blue are okay. Finally, pink tiles.
then I'll do anything. Step on them all you like. How was that? Understand? Understand the explanation? Yeah, sure. We'll go with that. Great! Then there's one last thing. This puzzle is entirely random. When I pull this switch, it will make a puzzle. That has never been seen before. Not even I will know the solution. Get ready!
Well, that's easy. See ya, Papyrus! Actually, that spaghetti from earlier, it wasn't too bad for my brother. Since he started cooking lessons, he's been improving a lot. I bet if he keeps that up, next year he'll even make something edible. Whoa. This is crazy. Oh my god. What is this? On the floor inside is a box of Palmer raisins. Palmer raisins. I get it. Aware of dog. Please pet dog. A dog just rushed in here, filled with inspiration. It kept trying to build a snow dog and express its own emotions, but as it built, it kept getting more excited about the sculpture. Its neck got longer and longer, and it added more and more snow until it was rather sad to watch, but I couldn't turn away. Knowing that the dog will never give up trying to make the perfect snow dog, it fills you with determination. Let's go ahead and save. Oh, okay. Hold on. Not what I wanted. Hold on, let's go down here. Oh, hey there. It's a snow papyrus. It's a lump of snow with the word sands written on it in red marker. That pretty much sums the two of them up. That is just great. Okay, so we go here, here, then up here, then over here, down here, 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 and here. Oh. Okay. Whee! Oh. That was weird. Down this way. Oh, hello. What's up? I was gonna ask you the same question. Hey, weren't you over there? Okay. Say, are you following me? No, I think you're following me. Oh. Gyftrot. Gyftrot confronts me. Looks like you got a lot of excess stuff on there. Some teens decorated it as a prank. Oh, go ahead and laugh. Oh, I'm fine. Okay, here we go. Ah, the scent of fresh pine needles. How about we undecorate you? Remove the barbed wire made of pipe cleaners. That's a little better. Okay, that works. Gyftrot is slightly less irritated. Undecorate you a little more. You remove the striped cane that says I use this tiny cane to walk on it. That's not a candy cane, but someone. Well, okay. That's a little better. Oop, there we go. And let's take another thing off. There we go. You removed a childhood photograph of Snowdrake and its parents. The weight has been lifted. Gyftrot's problems have been taken away. Let's go ahead and spare you. Okay. So what's this way? It's a door. Okay, but I can't go through it. Alright. Whatever. 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 We shall go forward, darlings. Actually, progress the story, as it were. It's a snowpuff. And this is a snowpuff. This, however, is a snowpuff. Surprisingly, it's a snowpuff. Snowpuff,
Is it really a snowpuff?
Behold,
a snowpuff. And this, eh? There's 30G inside of it. What is this? It's a snowpuff. That's what it is. And that is a doggy, apparently. Hello, doggy. Whoa, that's a big doggy. It's a greater dog. Okay. Let's beckon you. You call the greater dog. It bounds towards you, flecking slobber onto your face. Lazy little doggy. Greater dog is seeking affection. How about we... player pet. Pet, I think. Greater dog curls up in your lap as it's pet by you. You get so comfortable it falls asleep. Zzzz. Then it wakes up. It is so excited. Okay. Greater dog is patting the ground with its front paws. How about we play? You make a snowball and throw it for the dog to fetch. It splats on the ground. Greater dog picks up all the snow in the area and brings it to you. Now dog is very tired. It rests his head on you. Oh, there we go. Greater dog wants some TLC. I just noticed, look at the spear. It's actually both the spear. The spear has a doggy face, and then like its right wrist has a doggy face too. That's just funny. Alright, let's pet you. As you pet the dog, it sinks its entire weight into you. Your movement slows. I'm kind of afraid of that. But you still haven't pet enough. Aw, little doggy. Pet capacity is 40%. Let's pet you more. You pet decisively. Pet capacity reaches 100%. The dog flops over with its legs hanging in the air. Oh, there we go. Greater dog is contented. Spare you, doggy. Oh, look at that doggy. And now its butt goes up in the air. Okay, so let's see. Where are we now? Oh. Huh? Human! This is your final and most dangerous challenge! Behold, the Gauntlet of Deadly Terror! Oh. Look at the doggy at the end there. When I say the word, it will fully activate! Cannons will fire! Spikes will swing! Blades will slice! Each part will move, swinging violently up and down! Only the tiniest chance of victory will remain! Are you ready? Because I am about to do it! Well, what's the holdup? Holdup? What holdup? I'm about to activate it now! Huh. I don't know, I don't see anything.
That, doesn't look very activated.
Well,
this challenge, it seems, maybe, too easy to defeat the human with.
Yeah, we can't use this one. I have a skeleton with standards. My puzzles are very fair. And my traps are expertly cooked. But this method is too direct. No class at all. The way it goes. Now what are you looking at? This was another decisive victory for Papyrus! Nyah! Ha!
Okay. Well... hi there, Sans.
I don't know what my brother's going to do now. If I were you, I'd make sure I understand blue attacks.
Okay, will do. Welcome to Snowden. Let's go ahead and save here. The sight of such a friendly town fills you with determination. Go ahead and save, and what is my health is looking fine. Okay. So I think before we really finish this up, because we'll be caught up to where we were before, we've got to go and face Papyrus one last time. Well, not one last time, because we still have to face him one more after that. But still... we're gonna go and say hello to Papyrus, darlings.
Okay. Papyrus, where are you, buddy? Very mysterious in here, I believe. Human! Allow me to tell you about some complex feelings. Feelings like the joy of finding another pasta lover, the admiration for another's puzzle-solving skills, the desire to have a cool, smart person think you are cool. These feelings, they must be what you are feeling right now! I can hardly imagine what it must be like to feel that way. After all, I am very great. I won't ever wonder what having lots of friends is like. I pity you, lonely human. Worry not! You shall be lonely no longer! I, the great Papyrus, will be your... No. No, this is all wrong. I can't be your friend. You're a human. I must capture you. Then I can fulfill my lifelong dream. Powerful, popular, prestigious. That's Papyrus, the newest member of the Royal Guard. Music. Gotta get into the music, darlings. Okay, sorry about that. Let's act. Let's check him out. Papyrus. 8 attack, 2 defense. He likes to say, Nyah-ha-ha! Nyah-ha-ha! Okay. Papyrus is rattling his bones. Let's flirt with you. What? Flirting? So you finally reveal your ultimate feelings. Well, I'm a skeleton with very high standards. I can make spaghetti. I have zero redeeming qualities. I can make spaghetti. No, no! You're meeting all my standards. I guess this means I have to go on a date with you. Let's date later, after I capture you. Doesn't seem to really, do much to me. Spare you now? So you won't fight! Then let's see if you can handle my fabled blue attack! Okay, sure. I can handle that. That's pretty easy to deal with. Huh? Oh! Ah! You're blue now! That's my attack! Ooh, yeah, listen to that music, darlings. So good. Try to spare you. I wonder what I should wear. Jump as high as you can. Papyrus dabs some bone cologne behind his ears. But he doesn't have ears, though. What? I'm not thinking about that date thing! Oh, boing, boing. Oh, listen to that music, darlings. Whoa. Yep. Whoa. There we go. Papyrus dabs marinara sauce behind his ear. I don't know that that would be all that good. Yeah, don't make me use my special attack! Oop. Okay. Oop. Oh. Okay, there we go. Papyrus dabs MTT brand Bishy Cream behind his ear. Oh yes, go ahead and show off to the darlings out there. We'll go ahead and get the ratings through the roof. I can almost taste my future popularity. Oop. And jump. Jump. There we go, better. Whoa, ow. Not fair at all. Papyrus dabs MTT brand anime powder behind his ear. Papyrus, head of the Royal Guard! Oop, jump, no. And you. Papyrus dabs MTT brand cute juice behind his ear. Papyrus, unparalleled spaghettor! Spaghettor! Spag! Spaghettor! Skeletor! Something!
Skeletor! Ow! No! Whoa, okay. I'm safe. I'm still here. Papyrus dabs MTT brand attraction slime behind his ear. Undyne will be really proud of me. Whoa! Okay, there we go. And again. And once more. And yet again. Any more? There we go. Papyrus stabs MTT brand beauty yogurt behind his ear. The king will trim a hedge in the shape of my smile! And jump. And jump out. A little bit too late there. Papyrus realizes he doesn't even have ears. My brother won't. Well, he won't change very much. But, hey. Ow. Crud. I need to heal up a bit. Take some monster candy. You ate the monster candy and recovered HP. I'll have lots of admirers, but... But what? What exactly, Papyrus? Boop. Jump. Papyrus is trying hard to play it cool. I don't need to do that. Let's go ahead and spare you again. Will anyone like me as sincerely as you? That's really the question in the end, isn't it, Papyrus? I don't know if anyone will. I love you just the way you are, darling. Just the way you are. Silly, joking laugh and yahahas and everything. Papyrus is rattling his bones. Someone like you is really rare. Am I? Well, I guess I am just rather fabulous. My glam rock knows no bounds, darling. Papyrus is considering his options. And dating might be kind of hard. Okay. Hold on. Yep. Gotta not move. And not move. Okay, here we go. Oh, hey. Hi-yo. There we go. Papyrus whispers.
Yeah.
After you're captured and sent away... Whoa, okay. Whoa! Ow!
Papyrus is rattling his bones again.
Who cares? Give up!
There we go.
Ow!
Papyrus is preparing a bone attack. I should use more candy, though. Very unlicorice-like. You recover 10 HP.
Give up or face my special attack!
There we go.
Ow!
Nope. But we do this, that. Okay.
Papyrus is trying hard to play it cool. Yeah! Very soon I will use my special attack!
Okay, and here we go. And you. Papyrus is rattling his bones again.
Not too long and I will use that special attack! Come on already and out! And use it! Use it, darling! Show them how special it is!
Papyrus is cackling.
This is your last chance before my special attack!
Okay, out, 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 out. If you use too much of that candy, I guess. Papyrus is trying hard to play it cool. More monster candy.
Behold! My special attack! What the heck? That's my special attack! Hey! You stupid dog!
Hey. You're taking away the special attack.
Do you hear me? Stop munching on that bone! Hey, what are you doing? Come back here with my special attack!
Oh, wow.
I'll just use a really cool regular attack.
Papyrus is getting ready for a regular attack.
Here's an absolutely normal attack.
Oop. Okay. Oh.
Ow. Nope. That's not that very normal. Ow. Stop that.
Okay, jump you.
Jump. Ow.
Nope.
Doggy.
Why would you do that, dog? Cool dude. Okay. And... Whoa!
Jump!
Okay. Whew. And anything more?
Okay. Jump over you. And I'm like just a little bit nervous in case there is something more.
Well, it's clear. You can't defeat me. Yeah, I can see you're shaking in your boots. Therefore, I, the great Papyrus, elect to grant you pity. I will spare you, human. Now is your chance to accept my mercy.
Papyrus is sparing you. Sure, I'll spare you too.
I can't even stop someone as weak as you. Undyne's gonna be disappointed in me. I'll never join the Royal Guard, and my friend quantity will remain stagnant.
What should you say? Let's be friends. What a loser. Let's be friends.
Really? You want to be friends with me?
Well then, I guess
I can make an allowance for you. Wowie, we haven't even had our first date yet. And I've already managed to hit the friend zone. Who knew that all I needed to make pals was to give people awful puzzles and then fight them? You taught me a lot, human. I hereby grant you permission to pass through. And I'll give you directions to the surface. Continue forward until you reach the end of the cavern. Then, when you reach the capital, cross the barrier. That's a magical seal trapping us all in the underground. Anything can enter through it, but nothing can exit. Except someone with a powerful soul. Like you. That's why the king wants to acquire a human. He wants to open a barrier with soul power. Then us monsters can return to the surface. Oh, I almost forgot to tell you. To reach the exit, you will have to pass through the king's castle. The king of all monsters. He is... well, he's a big fuzzy pushover. Everybody loves that guy. I am certain if you just say, "Excuse me, Mr. Dreamer, could I please go home?" he'll guide you right to the barrier himself. Anyways, that's enough talking. I'll be at home being a cool friend. Feel free to come by and have that date.
Whoa. He jumps. Okay, well, before we go ahead and wrap this up here, and we'll come back for the live stream on Sunday here, let's go ahead and save. We'll come back and talk to you later, Papyrus. We got a date to go on. You better dress up too, buddy. But first, I forgot that I could have used a little thing to teleport me all the way over to the end of this, but we'll just keep going. Pardon me. Hello. Goodbye. And let's see. The sight of such a friendly town fills you with determination. Let's go ahead and save. Alright, well, thank you for going ahead and joining me, lovely darlings, here today on Undertale the Pacifist Run. If you have anything to say, if you like this video, go ahead and please give it a like and give it a comment. Please give it a subscribe, even. I always love to hear from you, darling, so please let me know what you think about this series. And of course, if you like these voice acting series, I always suggest that you go ahead and watch Blaster Brewmaster's playthroughs of Mario & Luigi Superstar Saga, as well as Paper Mario. He loves being silly and voice acting for all of these sort of things. In the meantime, go ahead and raise your glass of whatever you're drinking up in the air and have another one on Blaster Brewmaster. Love and peace, darlings, love and peace.
Professor Booster, can we bring him along?
I don't trust hippies!
Professor?
Huh?
Sue! Our escape must be put on hold for now! The doctor has found the location of the red flowers!
Huh?
As of yet, he doesn't have his hands on them! But it's only a matter of time before he does! Their location is Sandzone! I've heard that the red flowers are...